How's it going, guys? Welcome back to the channel. It's been a while, but thank you for sticking around. I will be playing 30 minutes today for you guys, as always, and it will be yet another episode of the dungeon playthrough. And well, we saw here that got hands on lantern, and that sort of solve this issue that we had with blue. We didn't know if there would be a lot more going on in this direction before we last episode, but now we have that knowledge and we can sort of consider this as ours, which is to our benefit. So what we need to figure out now instead is then we have some decisions to make. The way that we can exit this zone would be through here, subterranean gate, and the two-way. As we already have seen, the subterranean gate jumps us over here to Khaled, and then we see a big angel block over here, and it continues further along this path, and we just need to be mindful of that. That can be where we are going next. Then we have this pass over here leading to another zone, and that is also a choice we can do, and we have a lot of heroes close by. We have the, let's see, we have some of the army right here, and let's see, and we have Shakti right here, and so it would make sense to go up further this way. Another way we could go about moving forward would be to go here. And we lost the town to Orange, and he could go here and take down Claxton. So let me actually do something like that. What I don't want to do is to spend a lot of time going back and forth, because what that would do is give time for the opponent to build up. And let's see, there's firebirds here. So green is low on amount of towns, but he's also at the same time the most the strongest. So that can change quite rapidly if he's allowed to, let's say, chase down Teal over here. And that will not be good. We just have to be mindful of that, because right now we don't have a lot of income or money, and we have a lot of things to spend the money on. Let's see here. Oh, 10,000 shaft, 10,000 a turn. That's maybe not the worst, but we need to be mindful of that, and we need to travel with Octavia as fast as possible. And as you can see here, wait, that's not Octavia, this is Octavia. It will take 3 turns, minus 1 because we're going to end the turn, and it will bump itself down to 2. So yeah, I don't want to spend that much time. Oh, okay, Khaled can maybe be the difference here. So let's see, let's move her. I think it's a she. Wait. Yeah, it's a her. It's a she. Okay. So that we can bridge the gap there. And let's see, is there something we have overlooked? I don't think so. Quindon? No. So the only real issue we potentially can have is right here, and he can go through here, and then he would have access to Claxton really easily. And there's potential units here to be bought, but it will only be as a safety measure, and I don't know if I want to buy them. Oh, it's 2,000 a turn he can take away from us. Is it worth it to buy some more here? You spend some of the money. No, I think I'll risk it. He wasn't able to reach. That's really good. Okay, so I know a lot of you guys is looking at my playthroughs, and I'm really happy about that. Thanks a lot for that. And if you're playing on 200% difficulty, what you really should think about is using your scout heroes first, because it's going to give you more strategic overview of what is the best move next. I think in general, the way that you should go about heroes is that it's a lot of small decisions here and there, which overall determines if you become a good Heroes 3 player or not. The most consistency, I would say, is going to win you the most amount of playthroughs and matches in general. So I'm trying to work around this, that I know for certainty that I'm going to be doing. And I want to get the units here. And let's see, maybe I can get manticores. I want the manticores. Oh, I can't upgrade them right now, because I can upgrade them over here. Okay, and I could change some money around, but I need to do this and give some fast unit there, and let's see, 7, okay. Something like this is fine. Malekith can transfer so that he can go over there next time. And now they're bundled up here, but what is important is that now the army is on Khaled, so that we can transfer the army here. And I really wonder if I should open this block over here so that we can continue doing something. Let's see how strong orange is right here. So is it orange's strongest? No, it's not. It's Isra. Okay. So if we go through here, there's a hero here, but he's only level 2. I could cheese it, and I really think that it's necessary to move on and progress in this game, because as I said earlier, it is also about making sure that the enemy is not advancing faster than you are. Okay, so let's use her or him and do something like that, and give a fast unit and move around. Okay, so now Shakti has all the units, and now we can move. Let's see. Yes, Let's see. Let me take down this first. Yes, because then I could get the level exactly. And that's perfect. Okay. So now I have the, let's see, did he build up something that I need to see? I could get some shooters, but I don't have a lot of money, so let's try to avoid that. Let's save here, and let's get this fight going. And I don't lose anything, so I'll take it, and I'll accept it. And I have quite a lot of movement left on him, and I should block on take this block. Obviously, there's telltale signs that he was coming from this direction. Even more so that well, he's undead, right? And if you are close to an undead town, you'll see dwellings, external dwellings from the same faction. I don't know what this is about, because this is for dungeon, so there could be a dungeon town. There's also one for Medusas. I kept thinking about Nagas, which would obviously be wrong, but yeah, Medusas. So something tells me that this way I'm going to encounter Orange, and I'll take down this block first, and I want the experience, so I'm going to accept the battle. I'm going to leave a protection around my guys over here, because I really do not want these troglodytes to suffer. And I'll wait and see. They come forward, and it means that I'm going to shoot harder on those guys. Obviously, they're going closer, and I'm going to be within full range shooting. So I could sack one of those guys and draw one retaliation. So it's only if I think that the Scorpion Curse is not going to one-shot these guys. I don't think they will, actually. I don't think they will. Let's defend there. They are blocking the my troglodytes. And this one has no retaliation, so why not just poke at them? Let's do this one. Okay, that killed off everyone. So this one is not able to reach my troglodytes. And this one is definitely not. Am I able to take one hit by 18 of these guys? I think I am. And it was a one shot. Okay, but I didn't know. That's the point. Okay, and I could go forward, but I need to be able to do this trick. Leave out everything but the fast unit. You've seen me done this a couple of times already. And I'm basically doing the same trick here. So I get this town back, and I really need to be my... I think the next thing I want to do, because now I get even more money, I need to scout in this direction, and I need my best hero here to go this way, to eliminate Orange as fast as possible. And they're making quite fast turns, so that tells me that they are a little weak. See, oh, it was over here. Yeah, that's something we didn't even talk about as far as the beginning of this video. There's a block here, but nothing is coming from this direction. This is basically just going to yield us money, and that's fine. Let's put him here inside. Okay, so yeah, there's another Scorpicore over here, or Manticore, what is it called? Manticore. And let's see what we're going to do about that. I think we're going to do this. She is bringing back it like this. And let me bring those guys. Okay. I need the dragons, but I don't have enough software. Okay. But let's just wait on that for now. Let's see. Malekith. Exchange. Just like this. Okay. You can almost reach. Let's see. Sinka. She definitely. Oh, there's Sulfur. There's Sulfur. Okay, so there's a town up here. And that's fine. That's fine. Okay. But that tells us something, right? That tells us that this is not going to be a threat moving forward. And that's really useful. So let's go here. And exchange. Let's see if this is visited. Yes, it was. Fair enough. Okay. Jaeger needs to go here, and I think I want this guy to give me some vision as to what is going on in this. Wait. I like the sulfur. Okay, but I get some vision here and a lot of untouched things. It's also untouched, so no one was coming to this point onwards and was moving, you know, having second thoughts about the block here. But that's a very good tell, and we need those intels. I will build towards the treasury, 10% interest of every week. That's really OP, and that stacks, by the way. If you have multiple towns, you will still have the same benefit, so that's really useful. Okay, and I didn't even do the things that I told you guys about before. I apologize, but I try my best to use my scout heroes first, and I didn't do that there, I admit. But I think it's okay. What is that, Mercury? Do we want Mercury? No, we don't, but I can build up towards the city hall and the other times, or the other turns. Previously in this video, I didn't have the money to do it. So that's why I didn't check. Okay, so here we see Isra. Wow, it's earlier than I expected it. And there's even a rampart town here, and there's a citadel, but there's so. Let's see here. We have expert tactics, but he's still going to have one arrow tower. I think if I attack him, I'm only going to attack his main army there. Let's save here and see. I want to see. I win, but I take big losses, and I'm still going up against town. Okay, but that's I'm just learning something new. I thought because there was something on his hero and there was something on the town, then I thought that I would have to do two battles to get that far. Okay, it takes down one evil eye, that's okay. And I think I will do Bless here to do maximum damage, and he's doing Blind. Okay. And he's using 10 spell points on that. Let's see, yeah, well, I can't do a whole lot without him coming out. So let me just defend. I lose one, that's unfortunate. Let me cure and wait. And I can use all his spell points this way. I think that's the best bet. The battle is going to start. Let's see, can I make him come out? Let's do, wait, if I do dispel, I'm going to take away my buff as well. So let me do this and wait, and yeah, he has no spell points. Okay, defend and say, so this should be the end, and now he comes out. Okay, and I can probably take him down by with the troglodytes, so let me do something like that. And that was only two. Yeah, it really decreases when you you exit the the amount of damage is really decreased when you are still inside the town there. But yeah, let's see how far can she go. No, I think this is enough, almost enough to take him out entirely. And okay, defend, and there's no retaliation on there, but I think that will be overkill. So let me take down the empires here. Okay, so who is going to be attacked a lot? I wonder if I do this and I move it in there, if that's a good move. Because I can use the paralyzing venom here, and that could maybe be a good choice, but he's really going to be whammed. But I got the shield. Let's do it. And okay, let's shoot. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. But, let's see, defend. Okay. There's no more. Okay. Yeah, okay, maybe that was a mistake actually. Yeah, that was a mistake. That was a mistake. Okay, but we learned that, and that's fine. Let me see here. So I needed to wait for him to exit the place, and I can wham with the with the troglodytes. Okay. Yeah, that's going to give a lot of DPS. Okay. That's good to know. Yeah. That's crazy. That's really crazy. But yeah, I have to accept it, I feel. Otherwise it's going to be cheating. But then I take this town, and that's at least something. Okay. And let's look at orange. Now it's only, yeah, Let's see. I'm still the weakest, but yeah, I think right now I get 12,700 turns, so that is going to help me recover. So let's do next turn. Okay. And I'll buy a hero and I'll buy the labyrinth. And let's get some units here. And the same goes for over here. Oh, there's no need. Okay. So let's see. Yeah, I need to upgrade this one actually. There's too many. Okay, let me move ahead here. Okay, let me go do that. And let me scout here. Okay, I don't need that. Okay, I need to lose a hero. I can do that by going here. Good. And yeah, let's do that. Almost. Almost. So I will discard this one, and then I can buy someone over here. Get the Manticore and get it back. Yeah, well, it's a little slower than I would like to, but that's fine. Okay, so everyone is over here. So let me see what's going on. Okay, so there's Chena over here. Let me go back to the town and stay there. And let's see here. I have the money. I have the money for. No, wait. I don't have the ore for that. Okay. But we're taking some losses, but we're also taking down some towns, so I'm perfectly fine with that. So let me do next turn and see. There's green. Orange is backing off. Okay, so. Green was there. Okay. It's probably coming through here. Okay. I needed that vision. Anyway. But that's fine. Let's keep him here. And, okay. Let's see. Yeah, we can go through there and get here. Okay. Let's think about this. I got a little bit of, it's one day before day 7, so. I need to set it up so that, that I'm able to get the army next turn through. So let's see here. And it will get there. Malekith needs to go further. Something like that. And he will come through here, right? Yeah. So let me go through there. Okay, so let me do something like that. And then it will be the end of this episode. It's been a while since I played, so I had to shake up some rust, and I probably lost a little bit more over here on Fortune Keep than I needed to. But we managed to take down Fortune Keep and get a lot more vision, and we took down this block, and we saw what was up here, and we have a clear idea. We also took this town back, which we had in the earlier episode, and we are making progress, which is the point. And with the next week reinforcements, we can take another step towards eliminating them, all of them. But thank you so much for watching, guys. It's been a pleasure always, and if you're not already, give it a subscribe to the channel and like the video. See you guys later. Bye, guys.